Gary Adonato, Varsity Sports Network, and I'm joined by John Carroll football coach Keith Rawlings. He's our 2015 Varsity Sports Network Coach of the Year. Congratulations, Keith.
Thank you very much.
We've talked many times this year, 12-0 season for John Carroll. I don't think many people could have predicted that, except maybe you and your kids. You came back to John Carroll 2 years ago. You'd been here before, had a successful stint, but something different happened this time. I think the community bought in, and everybody is on the same page. Just talk about the dynamic of what's happening at John Carroll with the football program and why you're so excited to be a part of it.
Well, first, I'm blessed and honored. Thank you for this recognition for Coach of the Year. Really appreciate it. Just totally blessed. I mean, God has put his hand on this team, this community. It has been a very special year, and I think that it's taken a lot of people. There's a lot of help that comes from our alum has really been supportive with the new field and the new lights, and I mean, there's just a lot of excitement in the community. Our administration and support team at the school is really great. I mean, we're really it's a great place right now, and I'm really excited. I see the changes that are from 8 years ago when I was there to now are just, you know, they're night and day. So I'm very excited about the future. I was actually at school with Brian King. We're working on some eighth graders, you know, and we both have great goals for the program, Brian with lacrosse and myself with football, and we're excited to really continue. This season just it's a very special year. I've been telling college recruiters they're coming in at a bunch of our seniors, and we have some really great seniors that are going to be special college football players. But the leadership of these seniors and the goals that they had set and made back, in early March last year, and the very first one was to be 12-0. To leave a legacy was another one, which these kids really left a legacy. And just the way they did things, the way they handled things, the way they treated one another on the field, our younger guys were able to see that. And as a coach, you know, I got chills going through my body as I say this right now. That is special. And you know, when you have a really group of special kids and you have that chemistry and you come out to practice, everybody loves being at practice. There's no drama, there's no issues. It was great. So it's just a very special time. I'm going to miss these kids. It's a great, like I said, a great group of seniors. But we got some young guys that have understood this leadership and this role that these guys have played, and I'm seeing them in the weight room already. They're talking about 7-on-7 already. Obviously, with 70-degree weather, we could probably go out next week. So, you know, it's really exciting time. I'm really happy for the future.
And when you came in last year, you had to build some relationships. I mean, you had some ideas. There was some pushback. I remember the issue with the helmets and things like that. Mm-hmm. But it seems like now everybody understands, and everybody's moving. You made some compromises, and they made some compromises. So that's part of it, right?
I made a few mistakes along the way, and there is a tradition. You mentioned the helmet, and I value the helmet, and I value, you know, the Gray family, and what that gold helmet represents, and our guys really understood that after. We all got educated on, you know, how the helmet came about from Notre Dame. So, I think that, that was a distraction the year before.
Right.
I think that, we were committed to no distractions, and really, we had a really great spring alumni 7-on-7. I think it's going to really grow to be something special where alum will come back and come out and play in 7-on-7. And they were running around. It was a great time. So there is, they get to understand who I am as a person and what my goal is, and how I love up these kids, and our staff loves these kids. So I think that they got a chance to see where we're committed as coaches and what we want to do to bring, you know, honor and recognition to their school.
Sure.
Their school of John Carroll, and them being an alum can be proud. I think we've accomplished that this year, and we got, you know, more goals and more things that hopefully we'll do to make them even more proud. So.
And you talked about traditions. You've established some new traditions. You take the team away to camp every summer to West Virginia. Mm-hmm. What is the origins of that? Is something you did when you were a player, or just something that you read about? It seems to be very important to you and the team, though.
It's extremely important, and I tell people all the time, if you told me, you know, I would miss 2 weeks of practice for those 4 or 5 days up in West Virginia. I'd take the 4 or 5 days and miss a couple weeks of practice. That time and that bond is special. And you know, it's you know, there's if you go, there's a lot of success stories. You know, I mean, obviously we all know the movie Remember the Titans. You know how they took those guys away and they became close. You know, and kids get to know one another. And we get to know them. They get to know us as staff. So I think it's a wonderful time. You know, we only practice once a day. It's in the morning, and then we just have, you know, a lot of bonding time. The kids are on the lake. You know, we bring a pastor friend in from FCA, Joey Potter from Georgia. And we sit around bonfires and we talk about real life stuff. And then you see kids build trust when you are not vulnerable, when you make yourself vulnerable. And they can see, like, wow, you've had different things in your life that, you know, they're maybe experiencing.
Right.
So we make it, there's a lot of sharing. And I think when you do that, you build this family. And this was extremely a tight family. And these guys call themselves brothers. And you know, with all the problems that we have in our society today, and to see guys love one another. And that's the most important part that I think comes out of this season, is the love that these guys had for one another. And it's special, it really is. So, you know, that is the tradition, the camp. We're doing a few things differently at our games. You know, we took the other sideline. We don't go into the halftime anymore. We just stay right there on the field. We just kind of just go right behind our bench. All that time in and out of locker rooms, I don't know what purpose that serves. So there's some things like that, you know, some of the meals that we did together before games. So these seniors will have something to look back on and say, wow, that's what we did that year of 2015. So it's pretty special. You know, I love the comment on, we had an amazing staff. And Bill Lewis, you know, so much credit goes to him. He's our offensive coordinator. He actually was the one that stepped in the interim role before I was hired. Bill's a great friend of mine, and he's a heck of a coach. He worked with the Mazzoni system that we run, and he's mastered it. And we brought in Ken Brinkman, offensive line coach, and with Dave Port, who works with our receivers, and Jamal Johnson with our running back. These guys did a tremendous job, you know, with the offense. And, you know, I'm not an offensive guy. I may say go for it on fourth down, or hey, maybe run that sprint up play twice a game. Maybe I'll put the headset on for offense.
Right.
I'm not involved in the offense. I'm a defensive guy. I like to, you know, think that I am. So a lot of credit goes to these guys, and I'm really just blessed to have them. Defensively, I think we had a lot of young kids, so we needed a high-powered offense. So our defense next year, because we played so many young guys, we had a freshman. A sophomore didn't play his freshman year, a banged-up quarterback that didn't play the year before, playing another outside backer, a couple of young guys in the secondary. I mean, so we're gonna have a great returning group of guys. So I'm excited about defense next year.
Yeah.
So, but you know, is this a special group of guys that really made this all possible?
And taking off your coaching hat for just a minute, you had an incredible experience too to coach your son. You've coached both of your sons. You coached Kiefer. Who was a great player at St. Paul's, and Kurt Rawlings had one of the greatest seasons by a local quarterback in the history. I mean, it was the records that he set were right up there with anybody that's ever played. So, as a father, I mean, and you're a coach and you're responsible for all the guys, but as a father, to watch, especially since you're not an offensive guy, you were able to watch and just see what he was able to accomplish. I think it's got to make you pretty proud.
Oh, extremely proud. I mean, Kurt's worked very hard, and he's had a lot of people, you know, that have coached him up over the years that have made him who the player is and the young man he is today. But, you know, it's the game moves so fast from 1 week to the next, preparing for opponents, so sometimes I wasn't able to really enjoy him. And finally, the other day, I finally just had a few moments. I was standing on the sideline. I was kind of the ball boy at the Crab Bowl, and, you know, a couple of the coaches walked by, and they were saying things about Kurt, and I had a few emotional moments of being a dad for a moment, not focused about what defense they're on or what call to make as far as managing the game and the team. And so I'm really starting to enjoy it now, and very blessed and appreciate your recognition of him and some of the other the Sun paper and whatnot that have recognized him. We're as a family, we're very humbled and blessed by that. But it's to just see how he interacts with other coaches and other players. I really got to enjoy it the other day and started, right. Enjoying more time. I'm looking forward to the holidays of the four of us. We're going to go away and do a little skiing. Right. And so just, really kind of reflect back on the season. So, yeah, it was very special to have, the opportunity of coach, both my sons. And now I just have a whole bunch of other sons. I mean, there's so many of the boys come over for meals and things and hanging out with Kurt. I'll just have a lot more sons here in the future to coach up. So,
last question for you. We're still just a few weeks removed from the season, so everything's kind of fresh. But what are the one or two things that about this season you'll remember 25 years from now?
I mean, just the maturity of this group of seniors that I'll always remember, and how they were committed, and how a group of guys all got along. I mean, seriously, we would come out to practice, and it was so fun. And now we miss it because it's not part of our life. So 25 years from now, I'll definitely miss this group of seniors. And it'll be a memory because, it was the first year of turf, first year of lights, and we had a heck of a team. So that will always be a memory, right. For not only myself, but for a lot of people. So.